Hello there, my fellow brothers of the Firecast, and welcome back to another video on the military of the Tau Empire. As I promised in the last episode on the Devilfish, I do intend to bring you a bit more videos on the vehicles and units of the Tau at slightly more regular intervals. So today we're gonna talk about another quite famous vehicle known as the Piranha. I am your host, the Grimdark Narrator, and without further ado, let us see what we can see, shall we? The first time a TX4 Piranha was initially encountered and identified by the Imperium was during a diplomatic mission on the Tau sept world of Dal If, where it was being used as an unarmed diplomatic transport for the Watercast negotiators. However, it was during the Tauros campaign that the Piranha was first field-tested in a military application, and has been subsequently codenamed the Piranha by the Imperium. During the Tauros campaign's battle for Hydroprocessing Plant 23-30, Piranhas were widely deployed in support of remote sensor towers already in the area to provide Seeker missile support. This caused the 114th Cadian Regiment's relief column to be constantly harassed by missile strikes, and day-long battles were fought between Chimeras and Piranhas. This led to the relief column being delayed long enough for the Tau Hunter cadres to overrun the plant. Piranhas also played an important role in the desert warfare on Tauros, harassing enemy units with the support of Hunter cadres. They eventually pursued the Talarn regiments of the Imperial Guard as they withdrew back to their landing zone in the closing stage of the campaign. Ever since the Tauros campaign, the Piranha has been upgraded in both armor and armament, and has proved notably successful as a support asset for the Pathfinder teams. Piranhas have been a favorite of the Firecast ever since their introduction, quickly proving worthy of the praise being heaped upon it. Places within Firecast Piranha training programs are highly contested, and those that successfully graduate enjoy enhanced status among their comrades. The design of the TX4 Piranha consists of a sleek and light design of a central open-top chassis, which can seat two members. A Piranha is powered by a complex dual anti-gravitic and jet propulsion motive system, so that a vehicle glides over terrain. By manipulating the anti-gravitic plates so that the Piranha is pointed slightly skywards, the pilot can gain extra lift and clear terrain obstructions with ease. Two winglets are mounted on the side of the main engines. Each of these winglets fulfills a similar role to that of the lift fins on a Devilfish chassis, providing extra lift to keep the vehicle off the ground and also providing space for the two recesses specifically designed to carry a gun drone. Mounted on the front of the central section of the Piranha is a chin turret, which can be fitted with a burst cannon or a fusion blaster. The armor of the vehicle is made from a dense nanocrystalline metal, Theotok, that is light, malleable, strong, and corrosive resistant. The Piranha carries two crewmen. The crew member in the front seat is the pilot, while the crew member behind him operates the chin-mounted weapon system. However, when the Piranha is used as a non-combatant, the second seat is reserved usually for important Tau dignitaries such as an ethereal. Piranhas are used in a wide array of capacities, and formations range in size from lone vehicles to a team of up to five working in conjunction. These agile craft have countless uses within the Tau military. Their speed and heavy firepower allows them to serve in capacities as varied as armored escort, reconnaissance in force, tank hunting, flank attackers, supply line raiding, mobile reserve, and even, in extreme circumstances, sudden strike assassination. Larger schools of these deadly skimmers can use their burst cannons to annihilate enemy infantry, while smaller formations are ideal for eradicating scouts or dealing with unexpected enemy deployments. Lone Piranhas equipped with the deadly fusion blaster are proficient hunters of the enemy tanks. Using its speed, the skimmer will attempt to maneuver so as to target enemy vehicles in their more vulnerable side and rear armor. During an attack run, Piranhas are a blur of motion, and the crew are more likely to trust in their speed and jinking ability over any amount of armor. Using its jet thrusters and anti-gravitic engine, the Piranha glides on a planet's surface, and its twin crew are well able to hug the terrain and make the best use of any cover. Piranhas are usually found supporting hunter cadres, in the niche role of acting as a light combat, raiding, and reconnaissance vehicle, which can harass enemy infantry and armor alike. In a reconnaissance role, the Piranha is a direct match for the Imperial Guard's Salamander, as it can tackle other light vehicles. This is a desirable asset since first contact with the enemy is often a clash between the scout forces. It is thought that the Firecast observed and learned from the Imperial Guard's deployment of the Salamander, and have adapted the same tactics for their Piranhas. On the battlefield, Piranhas often seem to be everywhere at once, hurtling over friendly troops to counterattack approaching infantry, racing along the flanks to launch devastating enfilades at enemy armor, or streaking from behind cover to destroy vulnerable enemies. After so many training drills that press using coordinated attacks and mutual fire support, the Fire Warriors are well accustomed to the thrum of a Piranha soaring just above their heads, and they no longer turn to follow the sudden whoosh of air as they streak past. Piranhas have the ability to bring firepower quickly to wherever it is needed, but they are even more dangerous when working in conjunction with Pathfinder teams. Using marker lights, Pathfinders often set up Piranha strafing runs, ensuring that the Skimmer's volley of fire is as devastating as possible. In return, Pathfinders, which are in danger of being overrun, can request quick strikes by Piranha teams to help wipe out approaching enemies, or at least buy time for them to retreat. A couple of known tactical formations for the Piranha include the Firestream Piranha Wing. When a number of Tau Hunter cadres fight together, they make use of a higher level scouting force consisting of a number of Piranha squadrons. These so-called Firestream Wings are often called Piranha Swarms by Imperial troops. They are responsible not only for scouting terrain ahead of a multi-cadre force, but also disrupting the enemy forces. The main function of a Firestream Piranha Wing is to hunt and eliminate isolated enemy units. These Piranhas are often fitted with Seeker missiles, and their chin-mounted burst cannon is replaced by fusion blasters, making them exceptionally lethal armor hunters, especially when homing in on marker-light targets acquired by other units. For this reason, the wing often includes a Tetra Scout speeder team to support them in their hunt. A lone Piranha leads the formation, whose crew are a specially designated target acquisition team, trained to optimize the firepower of their comrades' craft by spotting vulnerable prey for elimination. The formation's lethal assault is enough to utterly shatter lone enemy formations, and eliminate enemy scouting forces entirely. However, during extended combat operations, the Piranha crews can withdraw, undertaking swift repairs and taking on fresh drone replacements before plunging back into the fight. The Firestream Wing's secondary function is to disrupt the deployment of enemy forces. They achieve this through a highly complex communications array mounted upon the wing command vehicle. This array gathers sensor data from all the Piranhas in the wing, and decrypts any communication it intercepts and identifies. The orders contained in the signal are altered, the encryption reapplied, and the signal reconstructed before being transmitted onwards to the intended recipient. Should the signal prove impossible to replicate, the system is capable of jamming any type of communication it can detect. The retransmitted signal is then intended to disrupt enemy orders, changing dispositions without the enemy command being aware of the subterfuge. Enemy units will often find themselves deployed kilometers out of line, and either ambushed or unable to take part in the main battle. Soon, the entire enemy army is in disarray, allowing the Piranha Wing and the following Tau units to engage the enemy entirely on their own terms. The Tau have become so adept at this process that they can analyze and jam almost any signal, and succeed in disrupting even entirely alien forces whose technology they have not encountered before. The Firestream Piranha Squadron. These are intended to provide heavy supporting fire for beleaguered Tau ground forces. They carry extra ammunition for their weaponry, but only have a limited amount of fuel. Should a Tau attack falter or a defense line start to crumble, Firestream squadrons will quickly be dispatched from a large central reserve to stabilize the situation. A TX-4 Piranha is mainly armed with an underslung nose turret weapon and a hull-mounted secondary weapon system. The nose-mounted main gun can be either a burst cannon or a fusion blaster. The burst cannon can provide rapid-firing suppressive and anti-infantry fire, which can harass and mow down enemy squads. The fusion blaster is an anti-vehicle, melta-type weapon effective against a range of both light and heavy vehicles, and allows the Piranha to fulfill the role of tank hunter on the battlefield. However, the fusion blaster can also be used effectively against heavily armored infantry. Piranhas can also be armed with two gun drones which ride with the vehicle in specially designed recesses. These gun drones are able to lend the Piranha their additional weight of fire to pin down the enemy, or they can detach and perform missions of their own. The TX-4 Piranha can also be equipped with any of the following upgrade systems: automated repair, advanced targeting, black sun filter, decoy launchers, disruption pod, flechette discharger, point defense targeting relay, sensor spines, target lock, and targeting array. Finally, before I leave you for today, here are some technical specifications as well. Its designation is that of a light skimmer, the vehicle type is a grav speeder, its crew consists of two guys, the pilot and the co-pilot, it weighs 4.5 tons, its length is 5.7 meters or 18.7 feet, its width is 6.4 meters or 20.9 feet, its height is 2.4 meters or 7.8 feet, and its top speed is 160 kilometers an hour. And this, my friends, has been what I wanted to tell you on the vehicle known as the Piranha Scout Skimmer for today. Another vehicle that definitely proves the Tau reliance on mobility in favor of very heavy armoring. Not to say that they don't have heavier vehicles, but the Piranha is definitely not one of those. If it were to have an Imperial counterpart, in my opinion anyway, outside of the Salamander, I think it is definitely the Space Marine Landspeeder. Is the Piranha among your favorite Tau vehicles? What do you like or dislike most about it? Tell us your thoughts, opinions and questions, if you have any, in the comments below. If you enjoyed the video, please click the like button and subscribe for future content. Thank you very much for watching, and I wish you all an awesome day. For the greater good.